Madam President, as on another matter, as the global leader of state-sponsored terrorism, Iran continues to threaten the very existence of the nation of Israel and destabilize the Middle East by creating a breeding ground for violence and hatred. For the past several years, the United States and our allies have attempted to contain Iran, often to no avail. For one, President Obama's lopsided nuclear deal left zero imprint on Iran's terrorist activities. So last week, the senior senator from Tennessee, the chairman of the Senate Foreign Relations Committee, introduced legislation to apply impactful and powerful sanctions on the nation of Iran. This bill will give the president the ability to block any trade that would benefit Iran's ballistic missile programs or support its military buildup. I plan to introduce a bipartisan amendment to this bill that would target Mahan Air. This is Iran's largest commercial airline that doubles as the preferred mode of transportation for terrorists and their weapons. That's right, it's a civilian airline, but actually is used to facilitate terrorism and to transport weapons. Mahan Air not only supports the efforts of the Quds Force, which is a special unit of Iran's Islamic Revolutionary Guard, but it also supports Hezbollah as well. This terrorist airline is a conduit for personnel, weapons, and a violent ideology throughout the region. And unfortunately, despite proven transgressions, Mahan Air continues to expand international operations by adding more international airports to its flight patterns, including several in Europe. This is an obvious threat to the safety and security of the people where these planes are allowed to land. Not only are the goods they transport cause for concern, their very presence is a security risk to Americans flying in and out of airports where a Mahan aircraft may land. And through all this, of course, Iran continues to support their terrorist activities, indeed carrying them on under the guise of commercial civilian aircraft flights. My amendment would require the Department of Homeland Security to compile and make public a list of airports where Mahan Air has recently landed, and then require the Department of Homeland Security to assess what security measures should be added. We have a duty to protect American citizens, and I'm thankful that Chairman Corker will bring this legislation to the floor. The fight against terrorism is multifaceted, and it's not easy, but we can start by targeting state sponsors of terrorism like Iran with economic sanctions while we strengthen our military and we continue the tradition, the great tradition of American leadership around the world. And finally, Madam President, let me return where I started to the issue of Obamacare. There's a lot of work to be done here at home as well. I know it's easy for us to get mired in the how, but it's also important for us to remember why we are repealing Obamacare and why we're replacing it with something far better for American families. I want to continue to highlight one of the many stories that I'm hearing from my constituents. I wonder whether the senator from New York is hearing from his constituents some of these same stories. Well, this is a small business owner in the Fort Worth area who told me that since Obamacare was implemented, this small business owner had been forced to change his insurance every year, every year. Can you imagine going through that headache and hassle when the president, President Obama, said if you like your health coverage, you can keep it? He also was the one who said if you like your doctor, you can keep your doctor, and he promised that premiums would go down an average of $2,500 for a family of four, none of which has proven to be true. Well, in this particular gentleman's case, as in the case for many Americans, his rates have gone through the roof, rising from roughly $350 a month to $800 a month. And despite the higher cost, he now receives less coverage because his out-of-pocket maximum has risen from $3,500 to $14,000. That's simply outrageous. Throughout the entire process, he's been fighting a losing battle. And as the case with many states, including Iowa, provider after provider has pulled out of my state as well. unable to afford Obamacare at all. So this small business owner is not only forced to find new insurance, literally every year, but he has to change providers each year, and he has less options available. And along the way, this is the other promise that President Obama made that has been broken. This gentleman has lost access to his doctor of 20 years. He refers to the hope he had when President Obama said when he looked in the camera and said, "Now listen to me, you can keep your insurance and you can keep your doctor and you'll pay less." That's what President Obama said when he was selling Obamacare. But instead, this gentleman, this small business owner from Fort Worth, didn't get to keep his insurance. He lost his doctor of 20 years standing, and he now pays nearly three times more for less coverage and higher deductibles. He closed his letter to me with a question. He said, "Can I count on you?" And I look around the chamber, and I want to ask all of us, can the American people count on us? I know they can, because it's our responsibility to provide something far better than what they've had under Obamacare. They can count on us if we'll work together to find solutions that actually provide the high-quality health care that American families deserve at the prices they can afford. And in many instances, this means getting government out of the way and allowing the marketplace to lower costs and increase quality, which is what markets do much better than government regulation. Right now, every senator on this side of the aisle is discussing with our colleagues how best to accomplish that. And we're also discussing this with the people we represent, the physicians, the healthcare providers, and others, to try to determine what the best way forward is. I hope that our Democratic colleagues would join us, rather than give us lectures from the Senate floor about the way we're conducting our business, particularly when their hands are unclean, to say the least, when it came to the way they jammed Obamacare down the throat of the American people to such bad effect. And I would encourage them, rather than just to obstruct, to actually work with us in a bipartisan fashion. We'd actually come up with a better product, a more durable product, if our Democratic friends would work with us, rather than just sit on their hands or actively obstruct our efforts to get the job done. So I would urge our colleagues from both sides to work together to find a solution that repeals what's broken in Obamacare and replaces it with patient-centered, accessible, and affordable health care. I hope eventually others come around to join us, if for no other reason than that their constituents are hurting by the status quo.